Hey guys, this video is all about testosterone and how to naturally increase it if your levels are low. Testosterone is known as the male sex hormone, but it's produced by both men and women. Men produce about 20 times as much. We also use more, so the levels in our bodies are around 8 to 10 times higher than women. Yes, women have testosterone, but far less, which is why it's so hard for them to put on muscle mass compared to guys. Men also have some of the female sex hormone estrogen, but again, women have 8 to 10 times as much in their body. So how do you check your testosterone levels? Some people claim that an easy way to check is to see if your ring finger is longer than your index finger. This is known as the 2D to 4D ratio, D being digit. But a more accurate way to measure would be with a blood test. Even with a blood test, you have to remember that time of day has a strong influence on your reading, and levels are generally highest in the morning. Here's an example of the variation across a single day. What does testosterone do? Most people would associate it with sex drive, aggression, maybe plentiful body hair. Low levels lead to a reduced sex drive, low mood, loss of muscle, weight gain, also gynecomastia, which is man boobs, and erectile dysfunction. Having optimal levels of testosterone will enhance strength, increase muscle protein synthesis, cause additional release of growth hormone and IGF, and reduce body fat, as well as reducing things like the risk of osteoporosis. So what is an optimal level? Well, that varies based on age, as you will naturally lose about 1% a year from the age of 30. For adult males, it's around 250 to 1100 nanograms per deciliter. That's 10 to the minus 9 grams per 100 milliliters. If you got your reading in nanograms per milliliter, that number is going to be 100 times smaller. I had mine measured in April last year, and it was in nanomoles per liter. To convert one to the other is a factor of 28.842. So the low end, 250 nanograms per deciliter, would work out around 8.7. And the high end, 1100, would be around 38.1. So my level was 15.5, multiply that by the factor to get 447, which is on the low end. This was taken around lunchtime, and I've already mentioned how time of day plays a huge role in your testosterone levels. An example, in a previous year, I had mine done first thing in the morning, and I got 22.9, which is around 660, around 50% higher. Some of the cofactors for low testosterone include high blood pressure, high cholesterol, being overweight or obese, and excessive alcohol consumption. Most of these are lifestyle factors that a good diet and regular exercise can fix. If we look at the science, we'll find some natural ways we can boost it. So in the male body, testosterone combines with an enzyme called aromatase to produce estrogen, which we still need some level of. The problem comes when too much testosterone has been converted into estrogen. Aromatase is found in body fat. So the more body fat you have, the more aromatase you have. Therefore, the more of it gets converted to estrogen, and you have an excess of something called estradiol, which is just one form of estrogen. Not only that, but the aromatase will have combined with more of your testosterone. So you're getting a reduction in available testosterone and an increase in estrogen, leading to a hormone imbalance. Drinking excessive alcohol will boost aromatase, in other words, making the problem worse. The opposite of a booster would be an aromatase inhibitor, a good example of which would be zinc or zinc-rich foods. Good foods would include celery stalks, red wine, obviously in low doses, olive oil, kale, parsley, and broccoli. Zinc and magnesium in the form of a ZMA supplement taken before bed would improve your zinc levels. It would also improve your quality of sleep. That's important because a study showed that in elderly men, poor sleep quality was correlated with a reduction in testosterone levels. Other studies have also found a link between sleep duration and testosterone. If you want more information about improving your sleep quality, I very much recommend reading Sleep Smarter. I've made notes on the book over at 9to5strength.com/books. Another supplement for testosterone and stress is ashwagandha, which has been shown to reduce cortisol, your stress hormone. Too much stress is going to have the opposite effect to what you want, so you're going to get less sleep, reduced muscle mass, and increased fat mass. Managing your stress is going to improve your testosterone levels. Again, I'll direct you to another great book, The Cortisol Connection. I've made extensive notes over at 9to5strength.com/books. Now, more about foods. There's been shown to be a high correlation between total dietary fat intake and testosterone levels. Several studies have shown that by increasing the fat intake, the subjects had higher testosterone levels. Here's an example where they were taking guys who had 40% of their calories from fat. They reduced that to 25% and then they put it back again. So that decreases from 22 down to 19, which is around 15% lower. In another study, they found positive relationships between percentage of calories from fat, saturated fat, and monounsaturated fat with serum testosterone. The same study found negative correlations with the ratio of polyunsaturated fat to saturated fat, and also the protein to carb ratio. While they make it look clear cut, if you look at the individual data, you'll notice one guy who's a bit of an outlier. If you removed him, then the other 11 subjects' data looks quite random. That being said, it's been shown that people who follow a low carb diet tend to have lower testosterone levels. So you should be eating plenty of dietary fat with the exception of polyunsaturated fat, which you want to moderate. High levels of polyunsaturated fat can be found in the foods listed here. However, Brazil nuts are recommended because of their selenium content. Another reason to avoid flax seeds is the high level of estrogens within the food itself. For that reason, you also want to limit your intake of soy products such as tofu and soy milk. If you wanted more monounsaturated fats in your diet, you would look to include some of the foods I've listed here. And contrary to popular belief, you don't want to eliminate saturated fat from your diet completely. For more on food, there's a lot of good information over at anabolicmen.com, including a top 30 foods for a natural boost. I've linked that in the description below. They mention limiting grains and instead opting for potatoes. Other foods I haven't mentioned already are up on the screen now, include things like organic grass-fed beef, or eggs, particularly with a runny yolk, onions, oysters, and fermented foods like sauerkraut. Dietary strategy actually falls into two categories. Getting your body to produce more testosterone in the first place and making sure that it utilizes more of the hormone in circulation. You can optimize your uptake of free testosterone with curcumin, antioxidants, and foods rich in vitamin C and E. Higher insulin sensitivity has correlated well with high testosterone, though subjects who are insulin resistant were probably overweight or obese in the first place. Either way, a diet rich in fruit and veg, limiting the added sugars and processed foods is bound to help you out. On to exercise, specifically resistance training, lifting weights, which was shown to increase resting testosterone by 40% in a previously untrained group. It also reduced their levels of the stress hormone cortisol at the same time. It's recommended you do big compound movements like the deadlift, squat, bench press, and bent over row as part of your routine. Lifting weights 3 to 4 times a week, making sure not to overdo it, is going to be optimal for you. The opposite is true of high volume endurance exercise, which has been shown to drop baseline levels by 20 to 40%. This is likely due to the increase in stress hormone levels compared to lifting weights. Now this is serious training, so it's not just going for a park run once a week. An example in the research was 2 hours of running 5 times a week. So that's more marathon runners and triathletes than your average weekend warrior. The study then asked the participants to stop doing 10 hours of running a week, and within a few months their testosterone levels returned to normal, so it isn't a permanent adaptation. So you can see our lifestyle is really not helping our testosterone levels. One long-term study found that they dropped by an average 1% a year over the 17-year study they did on American men. Another thing that's not really helping us is the environment. Estrogen and estrogen-mimicking compounds are found in regular tap water, with environmental estrogen said to come mainly from animal manure. That's because that's what they're using to fatten up the cattle, so your cheap, fatty cuts of GMO meat are also going to be packed with estrogen. Using a high-quality water filter would do a good job at removing it from your water. If you drink a lot of bottled water, you need to be aware of BPA. This is used in a lot of plastic bottles, and it contains estrogen-mimicking compounds that are going to leach into your water. Even then, a lot of BPA-free water bottles contain BPS, which is just as bad, so you need a BPA and BPS-free water bottle, a good example of which is Camelback. I've tried to be as thorough as possible while also keeping it concise, but if I've missed key studies or my information's out of date, or there's anything you'd like to add to the conversation, please post it in the comments below. Thanks for watching, guys.